today we're here in Irvine with our Analytics APIs engineers to get a little bit behind the scenes look of how the Analytics Data Export API was built. So Jacob, tell us a little bit, what is the Google Analytics Data Export API?
The API is basically a REST API, which means that you ask a URL, you phrase your question in the form of a URL, and when you visit that URL, it will return back data in XML format that contains the answer to the question you've encoded in that URL. Now, specifically with the Analytics API, there's two URLs that you can ask. One we call the accounts URL, or the accounts feed. And in that one, you can ask questions, for example, what accounts do I have access to? What profiles could I ask data from as a currently logged in user? The other one is the data feed, or the data URL. And in that one, once you already know what profile you'd like to get data from, you can ask it any question you'd like about what kind of data you want. For instance, you could ask for how many visits did this particular profile get in a particular date range, broken down by city, or sorted in a particular way, say sorted alphabetically by the city. Or you could say only visits in the city that came from Firefox. You could ask questions like that.
So that's great. So in the current web analytics, Google Analytics user interface, you currently can export through the CSV. You can also schedule the reports to be emailed to you. So that way you can get those different CSV reports in your email. How is the Analytics Data Export API different from what you can currently do today?
Sure. So the methods that you just mentioned are really good if you want to look at a particular report that already exists in the Analytics UI, and you want to look at it, you know, every day, or you want to integrate just that one report into maybe a spreadsheet. The Analytics Data Export API is more appropriate for larger scale tasks, like integrating analytics data into your business's own custom content management system, or building a gadget out of it, or making some application that you can then resell to other users that does all kinds of neat things that maybe the Google Analytics front end that we just haven't even imagined and programmed in there yet.
So with this new data export API, you know, you're talking about a lot of these great use cases. What are you really hoping developers will do with it?
We're hoping that developers are going to do crazy things that we haven't even imagined yet. You know, they'll be able to make business applications that integrate analytics data into their own systems, so that rather than having to do things like copy data out of many different reports on the web UI, they'll be able to just get all the data in a single program in a much more natural way. It'll be a lot easier for them. But also, you know, we wanted to open things up so that developers can make really cool applications, like, you know, the iPhone application, or alternate front ends, really interesting pieces of technology, different analyses that we don't do yet, different visualizations that analytics doesn't do itself. Anything that they think will make analytics more helpful, more useful, more interesting, more fun to use.